Good morning and welcome to our math lesson today. My name is Vincent. I'm here to take you through mathematics lesson 2. Subtopic, addition of fractions using LCM. As you know, in our previous lessons, you might have learned about LCM. So I just want to have a quick reminder of LCM. LCM means these are initials. It means the least or the smallest common multiple. This is the meaning of LCM. Least or smallest common multiple. So we are going to do addition of fractions with the different denominators, and we are using LCM in this case to come up with the answers we intend to have. So first of all, for example, someone would like you to give that person the LCM of a particular number. For example, someone tells you to give out the LCM of 9 and 12. Work out the LCM of 9 and 12. So you draw that tree, ladder. We are calling it a ladder. That's not the ordinary ladder, just a ladder in mathematics. So you look for a common factor. Common, the word is common, the one that can divide both. Therefore, you start with the least common, the common one. You start with 3. 3 can divide both. This is 9 divided by 3 is 3. 12 divided by 3 is 4. And then again, you can notice there is 3 here. You use 3, 1, then 4. Then you have 2, because of this 4, 2 will divide 4 twice. Here, of course, you have that one translated to the other side. And then you have 2, 1, because of this 2, divided by 2, you have 1. So our LCM will be the product of all these, which is going to be 3 times this 3 times this 2 times another 2. So, for this case, 3 times 3 times 2 times 2. This one is 9. This one is 4. Therefore, 9 times 4 is 36. So our LCM of 9 and 12 is 36. This one is just a reminder of what you did in your previous lessons. Now, today we are going to apply the LCM of any number by looking at the denominators of a particular fraction. And of course, the denominators are different. It's not like when they are the same. When the denominators are the same, for example, a quarter plus maybe 3/4. You see, the denominator is the same. Here we are not using the LCM. But if they are different, here it just comes automatic. The denominator again is 4. This one is 4. And you always know 4 over 4 is 1. This is just a reminder of what you did. But today, we are going to look at additional fractions with a different denominators. That's what we are going to do right now. This one has just been a reminder of what you did in your previous lessons. Now, We are going to, I'm going to take you through some examples. For example, you have 2/3 plus a sixth. 2/3 plus a sixth. Before you work out this question, look at the denominators, 3 and 6. So you go ahead, find the LCM of 3 and 6. That's where you start from. So LCM of 3 and 6. One more thing I have to remind you is that when you are doing the LCM, start with the smallest prime factor. Smallest prime factor of the numbers given. For example, the smallest prime factor of 3 and 6 is 2. So you have 3, because this one cannot divide this one. 6 divided by 2 is 3. And then again you go to 3. 3 divided by 3 is 1. 3 divided by 3 is 1. So your LCM, in this case, will be the product of this. Product means multiplication. So you multiply these two. So 3 by 3 will give you 6. Therefore, your LCM is 6. Use this 6. So 6 divided by 3 will give you 2. 2 multiplied by 2, rather, it must give you 4. So this one is given as 4. Then added to 6 divided by 6. Is 1. 1 times 1 is 1. Therefore, we can conclude that 4 plus 1 is 5 over 6. So we can say that with the use of the LCM, we can comfortably work out the value of 2/3 plus a sixth to give you 5 over 6 or 5 sixths. This fraction can also be written in words as 5/6. This is what you've been doing since January. Now, that was the first example. This is example 1. We are going to example 2 and 3 before I give you some assignments to work out. The next question is the next one is here. Three eighths plus a third. I told you, if you remember what we did here, after writing it like that, you go straight to looking for the LCM of the denominators. The denominators are the lower numbers. The numerator are these ones. 3 and 1, these two are numerators. And these two here, the lower ones, are the denominators. So when I'm talking about look for the LCM of the denominators, look for the LCM of these two. So therefore, you are looking for the LCM of two numbers, 8 and 3, the lower numbers, 8 and 3, LCM of 8 and 3, 8 and 3, so look for the LCM of these two, 8, 3, we said we are going to start with the smallest prime factor. Start with the 2 because 8 is divisible by 2. So 8 divided by 2 is 4. 3 divided by 2 is not possible. Leave it like that. Again, 2 can divide 4. So 2, that one is 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2. 3 divided by 2 is not possible. You go to 2 again because of these 2. Alright? Then, I hope, planner, you are following what we are doing here. Before you decide what factor to use, look at the numbers. And I said you should be ascending in terms of the prime factors you are using. So 2 divided by 2 is 2, 3 divided by 2 is not possible, still have 3.
sorry, 2 divided by 2 is 1, not 2.
But I found was a wrong calculation.
Therefore, 3 remains here. So divided by 3, this one is already 1, this one is 1. So the product of all these will give you the LCM of 8 and 3. This is 2 times 2. 2 times 2 is 4. 2 times 3 is 6. 4 times 6 is 24. So our LCM is 24. So we come here, ask ourselves, 24 divided by 8. The answer is, Lana, the answer is 3. 3 times 3 will give you 9. 24 divided by 3 is 8. 8 times 1 will give you 8. So if you add these two, 9 plus 8, 9 plus 8, what is the answer? You might have found 17 over 24. Once you find the answer to be 17 over 24, look at the answer, whether there could be any common factor that can divide both numbers. If it is there, you simplify. If it is not there, you leave it. For example, this one does not have any common factor that can divide both. Therefore, we just leave it the way it is. This one, the answer to 3 eighths plus 1 over 3 or a third is equivalent to 17 over 24. Finally, class, I want to give you some assignments which will be given later in your textbook. Thank you and have a nice day.